cancer, early screening, and diagnosis. Welcome to my channel. This is Alema Health Matters. Is this your first time? I urge you to subscribe, like this video, and also share. You can also comment on the comment section and share your views about this video. And don't forget to hit the notification button so that you will be notified every time I post a new video. This episode objectives, we have three objectives, which are the common cancer signs and symptoms, cervical cancer, screening and diagnosis, breast cancer, screening and diagnosis. Welcome and stay tuned. Now, what are the common cancer signs and symptoms for different parts of the body? We start with the cervix. Excessive vaginal discharge. Postcoital bleeding. Those are the common signs and symptoms for cervical cancer. For breast cancer, if there is a lump in the breast, asymmetry of the breasts, eczematous changes in areola, breast skin retraction, blood stained nipple discharge, recent nipple retraction, you should suspect breast cancer. For prostate, frequent nocturnal urination, difficulty in urination, you should suspect a prostate cancer. For colon and rectum, blood in the stool, changes in bowel habits, unexplained weight loss, anemia, you should suspect colon or rectal cancer. Nasopharynx, nodes in upper part of the neck, nose bleeding, permanent blocked nose, deafness, you should suspect nasopharynx cancer, oral cavity, ulceration in mouth, white lesions, that is leukoplakia, or red lesions, that is erythroplakia, you should suspect a oral cavity cancer. For the larynx, if you have persistent hoarseness of voice, stomach, upper abdominal pains, recent onset of indigestion and weight loss, you should suspect stomach cancer. Testes, swelling of one testicle, you should also suspect testicular cancer. Urinary bladder, blood in urine, and easy urination, pain urination, frequent urination, you should suspect cancer of the bladder. Skin melanoma, patchy coloration that may itch or bleed, brown lesion that is growing with regular borders, you should suspect a skin cancer. Let's talk about the cervical cancer screening. Women above 30 years presenting with any of these symptoms and at the same time associated with a palpable pelvic mass or clinically detected cervical growth or ulceration, these women should be screened for cervical cancer. The symptoms include vaginal postcoital bleeding, vaginal bleeding between menstrual periods, postmenopause vaginal bleeding, false smelling vaginal discharge, pain during vaginal intercourse. Those are the common symptoms. If a woman above 30 years present with any of these symptoms associated with a palpable pelvic mass, this woman should be screened for cervical cancer. For breast cancer, women of reproductive age presenting with any of these symptoms should also be screened for breast cancer, that is, a breast lump that enlarges and it's fixed and also hard on palpation, a breast lump, a change in the shape or consistency of the breasts, unilateral bloody nipple discharge, lump in the axilla, eczematous breast skin changes, nipple retraction, and lastly, nipple ulceration. This is a woman who should be screened for breast cancer. This is the last part of our presentation. If this is your first time, I urge you to subscribe, like this video, and also share. And thank you for watching.